Good morning, dear chair, dear colleagues. We'll try to evaluate retinal and choroidal vascular changes in macular telangiectasia type 2 patients using spectral domain optical coherence tomography angiography. We evaluated 40 eyes of 20 patients and 36 eyes of 18 controls. We performed fundus fluorescein angiography, autofluorescence, SD-OCT, AD-OCT, and OCT angiography with complete ophthalmologic examination. Those cases with ocular diseases or surgery, additional systemic diseases, and high refractive error higher than 3 diopters are excluded from the study. We performed superficial capillary density and foveal avascular zone and choroidal thickness were compared. And OCT-based macular telangiectasia classification are used as in the figure. Those with grade 1, the temporal micro telangiectasia, and grade 2 is both temporal and nasal telangiectasia and the presence of 360 perifoveal telangiectasia grade 3 and association of associated choroid neovascularization grade 4. And there was no difference in between the patient and controls with respect to age. And the patient group showed significantly less full macular thickness, inner thickness, and outer thickness of the parafoveal region. And choroidal thickness was significantly greater in the patient group, whereas the whole vessel density was significantly less in the patient group. Choroidal flow and flow index were also significantly different in the patient group, especially the choroidal flow is significantly less in the macular telangiectasia patients. As we know, Müller cell dysfunction is the main pathogenesis in those patients, macular telangiectasia, and up to now, fundus fluorescein angiography, as we all know very well, gold standard, but insufficient to show in capillary plexus changes and choroid neovascularism membrane. On the other hand, OCTA includes both OCT imaging and allows us detailed evaluation of the microvascular structure. Using OCTA, early changes, especially in the deep plexus, followed by superficial and choroidal anastomosis is possible. In our study, we showed superficial capillary density loss, foveal avascular zone expansion, and flow decrease in choroid in macular telangiectasia patients. In the literature, similar results have been shown, and the choroidal thickness increase has been shown as a compensatory mechanism against the disease, and it gives a good response to anti-VEGF treatment. And lastly, the potential limitation of our study it resulted from some motion artifacts due to poor fixation, due to low vision, and difficulty in segmentation of the retinal layers due to the retinal atrophy in the presence of the collapse of retinal layers, and lastly, the low number of the decreased eyes due to scarcity of the patients, and more definite conclusion could be drawn with larger sample in the multicenter studies. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Yusuf, for this excellent presentation, and I have one question. Do you think this finding or your finding can help us knowing more accurate etiology for this disease?
I think the main pathology may be resulted from the choroidal choroid may be the main point of the disease because especially the flow the low flow in the choroid may be the main starting point of the macular telangiectasia because the low nutrition and the choroidal ischemia may potentially lead to Müller cell damage and that secondarily may lead to the formation of the macular telangiectasia. Okay. This is what we guess from our study, but fine.
Okay.